Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. In the previous tutorial, we learned about the Python Package Index, a repository of software for the Python programming language. That gives us a great foundation to understand in a little bit more detail the process of installing the Django framework. In this tutorial, we go ahead and install Django from the Python Package Index utilizing Pip, the Python Package Manager. And I'll give you some more information about how to view installed packages in your virtual environment. And in addition to that, we'll go ahead and we will create a requirements file. I will make the assumption that maybe you've accidentally closed Visual Studio Code. Now, in the previous tutorial, we did make a project folder and we also created a virtual environment. So you'll need to go ahead and file, open folder, and open that folder we created. Now, we do have this recent section here, so I can just click on the folder that I was working with in the previous tutorial, which was a folder called First Django Project. So if I click on that, you can see that activates the folder on the left-hand side here, and this is the virtual environment we were working within. So now I can go ahead and open up the terminal, drag up. Remember, I used the shortcut there, but you can also go to View and have a look at the shortcut for that, or just open the terminal up here. So I'm just going to go through and start the virtual environment. Here I'm on the Mac, remember. So it's source vmv /bin and then activate. If you're on Windows, it's going to be slightly different. There is a tutorial for that if you can't remember. Right, so now I'm in the virtual environment. I can now go ahead and install Django. In the previous tutorial, we learned that Pip was the Python package manager, which will allow us to download and manage packages from the Python package index. So let's go ahead and type in Django. So if you're not too sure what package you need to download, just go back into the Python package index, head over to pypy.org, type in Django. That should give us a list here. Up the top here is the Python package, the Django framework, apologies. So go into Django here, and you can see the command that we need to utilize. So I'm just going to copy that. I'll go back to my command prompt here. Well, I don't need to copy that, Django. So pip install Django. So we're now going to download Django from the Python package index. You can see that just took a couple of seconds to do that. On yours, it might take a little bit longer. The process of installing Django is a fairly straightforward process now you've seen. So let's take a look at now how to view the installed packages. What we need to remember here is that we're working within this virtual environment. So when we download any packages, that's going to be downloaded and utilized within this virtual environment only. Now, when we download packages, if we go into this library lib folder here, you can see that in actual fact, we have Django. That's what's just been downloaded. In addition to that, you can see the other tools that we have, for example, pip, for example, that's the tool that we utilize to download Django. Here are a few commands, important commands, that it's well worth making a note of. Pip install. So we've utilized this command to install software, pip install. If you wanted to uninstall packages, we can use pip and the uninstall command. The dot 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 here refers to the name of the package that you want to install or uninstall. We can also list packages that are currently installed. So let's take a look at this. So pip and then list. So if I move up here a little bit, we can see that there are a number of different packages that are installed here. We have the ASGI ref package, Django pip, setup tools, and SQL parts. Being able to recognize the versions of software or packages that you have in your environment is going to be very important if you want to replicate your virtual environment so that you can maybe start developing on another computer, or potentially if others are also developing the same application. Typically, you want everyone to be utilizing the same version of packages. So to ensure that everyone has a consistent environment when developing the application. Without going into too much detail, we can imagine that, for example, Django 1.0. If we wanted to utilize Django 1.0 now, the code in that version of Django is probably going to be completely different to the code base in Django 4.1.1. So if we were to write a program for Django 1.0, it is likely that some of it or all of it wouldn't work with this version here of Django. If we would like others to be able to replicate our environment, we need to make sure that they know what packages have been installed in our environment when we're developing our application. What we have here is a last command we can make a note of is the pip freeze and then the right chevron and requirements.txt. Now, the name of this file can be absolutely anything you want, but the general kind of de jure standard, the general practice is to utilize requirements.txt. So let's now just utilize that command. So pip freeze and then the right chevron here. And then we're going to say requirements.txt. So what we're doing here is we're freezing. And essentially that means capturing all the packages that are currently installed in this virtual environment. And then we're going to record that in this file here. So we're going to create this file and then copy all of the names and versions of the applications that are installed or packages that are installed in our virtual environment onto the requirements.txt file. So if I do that, we can see that the requirement.txt file appears. We take a look, you can see that we now have three packages installed. So you might be asking yourself, well, if I use pip list here, in actual fact, it's listing more packages here than what's on the requirements.txt. This is because pip and setup tools, these are just two built-ins that are created when you create the virtual environment. So they aren't included in the requirements.txt when we freeze. So in actual fact, when we downloaded Django or installed Django, Django required other dependencies in order for it to work correctly. And that's these other tools here, these other packages that you can see here. Of course, if you wanted to explore what these packages were, we just need to copy them, go over to the Python package index and take a look at what they are. We can see that this package is required in order for us to successfully run our Django application and communicate with it so that it returns templates, etc. to the browser. SQL parse, so let's take a look at that. SQL parse. So this is a non-validating SQL parser for Python. It provides support for parsing, splitting, and formatting SQL statements. To translate that, SQL parse is a module which provides functions which will help Django achieve some common tasks when working with SQL statements. We don't necessarily need to know anything about these two packages here, so you don't necessarily need to spend any time on that. But what we have learned is that sometimes when we download packages, in actual fact, they require other packages to work correctly. You can see that that was an automated process. When we install Django, it would also install the other packages that was needed. So that isn't something that we need to necessarily think about or explore when we're downloading packages from the Python package index. That should be an automatic task. Okay, so we're finished here by just reiterating that I will show you a little bit more about the requirements file and how to start up a Django project from a requirements file later on in this section of the course.